Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and behind the camera is my wife, Connie. I'm glad that you joined us. Have you decided that perhaps hammock camping just isn't for you, but yet laying on the ground is just, it just doesn't get it? Well, maybe a cot like this is the answer. We're going to make this cot in the video, so stay with us. And we'll get down to the nitty-gritty on how this is done. So here is my old cot. Okay, now this is canvas, and I made this about 30 years ago, and it has served me very well. But canvas is bulky, it's heavy, and it's prone to water damage. It's slow to dry out. So I need to make a new one. Now, there's several ways you can go about this. Now, before I start explaining this one, let me explain this one. This is the Amazing Wilderness Camp Cot Jeep. Sells these over at Econo Challenge on YouTube. So check him out if you're interested. Now, it's a great product. We've used it several times. It fits in its own pocket here, which is really cool. But it just doesn't work out well for me, and let me explain why. I'm a side sleeper. Alright, so we'll show this end. Okay, this is made in a tubular fashion. You're looking at the end here. You're going to slip where my hands are, each hand, you're going to slip a log down through there, which will keep this spread out, and you'll sleep on that. But I'm a side sleeper, and this just doesn't, you know, after you put the logs in, there isn't enough room for me to lay sideways on here. My knees are against the logs and on top of the logs. My back is on top of the logs, so it just doesn't work well. Now, if you are a stomach or a back sleeper, then this would probably work out great for you. Connie, she is a stomach sleeper, and she really likes the cot. And especially if you don't want to make your own, check out Jeep, the Amazing Wilderness Camp Cot on Econo Challenge YouTube channel. Well, this is how big the cot, my finished cot is, the cot we're going to build, and contrast that to the canvas cot. There's the difference. This is 22 ounces. This is 11 ounces. So let's get started in building it. Now, as I said, there's several different ways you can make this. This one is tubular, okay? Now, this uses relatively the same amount of fabric, perhaps, but you sew in sleeves rather than one tube. You put a tube on each side. Now what that does for you is instead of these two ends here, see, I ran the fabric, overlapped it, sewed it together. Now, instead of these two ends here that were overlapped, instead of them being together and then it being a tube, this allowed me some extra width. And this has worked out really well for me through the years. But as I said, canvas is heavy, canvas is bulky, and it's susceptible to water. So let's make a new one using this style, using these measurements, and make it out of nylon. I'll show you how. Now, before we get started on making it, I've determined that this width works out well for me. And it is approximately 37 inches wide. Now, once you put a log in here and a log in here, spread that out, the width between those two works well for me. Now, if you're a taller person, longer between your waist and your knees, then maybe you might want some more width. That I'll leave that up to you to figure out. Now, let's go get started and putting this together. Okay, what you do is you start on the end and you flop it over once and then flop it over again and then sew it. So this is what the end looks like. Let's start on the other end and I'll show you how it's done. Okay, now what we need to do on this raw end is fold it over about roughly 3/4 of an inch and we'll iron that. Okay, we want this on the warm setting, about the coolest your iron can go. Just to kind of help hold that fold a little bit. As you see, it's not going to go down real well, but it will help put a crease in there. Just help overall. And you do that all the way across. Now that you've got it creased all the way across the end once, what we're going to do now is we're going to fold it over. Now we're going to pin that. So run a pin through, back out again. Go on here about roughly 6 inches. Now notice I said roughly. None of these measurements are real critical, just approximate. Okay, you can do that all the way across the end. Okay, we've got it pinned. We have it folded over so that we have a tri-layer here, three layers. And we're just going to go along and iron it down in between each of the pins here, just to make it a little bit easier to handle. Now, length of material. This is approximately 58 inches wide. That's how wide it came off the roll. And that'll work just fine. I'll show you how to handle that. Length, I bought 2 yards, so it's 6 feet long. Okay, you want to pull out each pin as you get to it, before you get to it, to help avoid breaking your sewing needle. Now, you don't have to be real accurate with your seams here. If you could see my seams, you would know what I mean. So we'll go ahead and sew up this end. All right, now what we've done is we want to overlap this about 9 inches to give us a 9-inch sleeve. That'll fit quite a wide variety, a wide range of poles. And that'll give us the 37 inches roughly of the finished product, our goal that we're trying to achieve. So how that ended up, we measured in 18.5 inches and marked it. And then we did that every so often going down the length of this and then folded it over. So here's a mark right here. I don't know if you can see it in the camera or not. We pinned it there, and we pinned it here at this mark. And then we just fill in with pins in between. We'll do that on both sides, and then we'll sew that together. Before we go on, okay, how I showed you to fold the end and then fold it again and sew it, we did the same thing on the sides. So all four sides have a fold and then a fold. And then now with the sides, then we will fold it over again and sew it.
Now this nylon, I don't know how heavy it is. It's it's a fairly stout nylon. And the thread I'm using is polyester. I did that because I want it to be stand up to water quite well, not rot very easily. We are done. It is finished. So, let's take it outside and try it out. Well, here's the finished cot. And if you've never slept on a cot, you can't imagine how comfortable they can be. This is every bit as comfortable as a commercially made cot. As I was saying, I'm a side sleeper, so I tend to sleep like this. And as you can see, this ended up being plenty of room to do that in. Well, thanks for joining me, and we'll catch you guys on the next video. You take care. Have a good week.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.